Oh my god, look how tiny it is.
Good day. This is the Insta360 GO Stabilized Sports Action Camera. It's been on the market since the fall of 2019 with the ability to capture HD photos and 60-second video clips. No big deal, right? Lots of cameras have that ability. And what's this got to do with FPV? Well, first of all, it's advertised as the world's smallest stabilized camera. You know those smooth GoPro film videos using hyper-smooth or real-steady video stabilization you've seen from FPV freestyle pilots? Well, the Insta360 GO has something similar called FlowState Stabilization. It works really well for cinematic-type flight videos, but locks the horizon so when you're doing flips or rolls, the horizon stays the same and the video doesn't flip and roll with your quad. It makes for some interesting shots, but it doesn't give you the full effect of FPV aerial acrobatics. So, we have a small HD video camera capable of shooting 60-second clips that won't do flips or rolls with our FPV aircraft. So why am I doing a video on this? Well, just recently, things have changed. The folks over at Insta360 have given us FPV pilots some features too good to ignore. Today, I'm going to explain what those Insta360 GO FPV features are, how you can use them, and with a couple short flight clips, I'll demonstrate for you why this is the most versatile, stabilized HD video camera available and ideally suited for micro FPV drones. Sound good? Then give this video a thumbs up below, share it with your pilot buddies, and subscribe to your TMac FPV channel, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff.
So here's the Insta360 GO. It's about the size of my thumb, and the advertised weight is 18.3 grams. Mine comes in at 18 grams. For comparison purposes, here's a 2S 300 milliamp hour LiPo, which is normally used on a whoop type quad. This comes in at 22 grams. And this is everything that comes in the box. You, of course, have your camera, which is a good thing. You've got a card which states that it's IPX4 water resistant, not waterproof. However, it does also state that it can be submerged for up to 10 seconds. You've got an Insta360 GO quick start guide, which is 13 pages in length, but looks a lot thicker because it comes in various languages. You have a micro USB to USB cable, and you also have an OTG cable for use with your phone. It comes with various accessories for mounting to include a clip, this pad with a sticky substance on the back, as does this have a sticky substance on the back. This is very handy because it's adjustable to different angles. And this part screws off. So if you wanted to, you can mount this on a tripod. This, of course, is the charge case, which is also what you'll use to connect to your phone to use the associated Insta360 GO app. This is a medallion, which is magnetized, which you can wear around your neck. This goes under your shirt, and then you stick the Insta360 GO on the outside of your shirt, and you can use it as a chest cam, which could come in handy if you want to videotape your transmitter sticks as an overlay to your FPV video flights.
This is the Insta360 GO app that you'll want to download on the Apple App Store or on Google Play for your Insta360 GO. This app is how you control the settings for your camera, as well as how to edit your videos using your phone. There are a couple other downloads that you may want to consider using for your Insta360 GO camera, and you can get those at this URL on the Insta360 site. It's got the camera control app, which you'll need, but it also has Insta360 GO firmware for firmware updates, and also the desktop software for your Insta360 GO. This is how you can edit your videos directly using your computer as opposed to your phone, should you choose to do so. Now, within the Insta360 app description, you scroll down here and you'll see what's new. And here they describe that you can now shoot 5-minute FPV videos with Bluetooth control. And I mentioned that previously, but it also states that we now have FPV stabilization mode available for FPV videos. This is the most recent update for us FPV pilots, and I'll show you how to go ahead and activate that feature using the app here in just a minute. If you go to the Insta360 site under support, product support, go, standalone operation, you'll see that the default modes are listed here. With the camera powered off, if you press the action button once, it's going to activate the quick capture function. Or if you turn the camera on and press the action button once, it'll take a photo. You can also have hyperlapse mode and slow motion mode. The reason I'm describing these is because when we go to FPV mode, we have to turn off the quick capture function. So if we go to support, product support, go, camera tutorial, view more, FPV mode, we get the instructions we need to activate FPV mode prior to recording videos. And we need the app in order to activate the FPV mode. It also contains warnings about how you need to start flying your quadcopter as soon as possible after activating it to avoid overheating the camera. Because if you try to use this 5-minute FPV mode without air circulating around the camera will overheat. So these are the instructions that we'll use prior to recording any video using the Insta360 GO app to activate our FPV mode setting. We simply connect our Go to our phone via the charge case, which I demonstrated earlier. Open our Insta360 GO app, tap settings, camera button settings, and then we turn off the quick capture mode. Select the button prompt we want to use to assign the FPV mode to. Choose standard video and set the recording length to 5 minutes. After choosing the settings, we disconnect our Go and press the assigned button prompt to turn on the FPV mode and start recording and start flying as soon as possible after we start our recording. And that's all there is to it for FPV mode. Now, FPV stabilization mode is a little bit different, and we do that through the editing function of the app after we've recorded our video. I'll go ahead and demonstrate that now, since we're already talking about the app, and then I'll wrap this video up with our demonstration flights using the Insta360 GO FPV features of FPV mode as well as FPV stabilization. So let's go ahead and take a look at how, after we've recorded the flight video, we can use the Insta360 GO app and edit our video with FPV stabilization and basically unlocking the horizon. Okay, to demonstrate the activation of FPV stability as opposed to flow state stabilization, I'm going to use the Insta360 Studio 2020 desktop software application. First thing we need to do is connect our Insta360 GO charging case with the Insta360 GO camera in it to my desktop computer. Now, what I found is it doesn't work for me when I go through a USB hub. I have to connect the USB cable directly to a port on my desktop computer. So we'll go ahead and do that and upload our file. And when we do that, normally it takes 2 to 3 times of the computer trying to connect with the camera before it actually makes the connection. Let's go ahead and give that a shot. So now with our file loaded from the Insta360 GO camera to our Insta360 Studio desktop application, we can go ahead and do minor edits with this particular software. It's not a fully capable video editing software program like Adobe Premiere at this point in time. However, it does do some basic editing capabilities. Specifically, what I wanted to show you here is it's got the ability to change from flow state stabilization to FPV stabilization, which will unlock the horizon. Now, when I make this change, it's going to rotate this video orientation 90 degrees. In the desktop application, I have not figured out a way yet to rotate it back. So prior to exporting, we're going to turn on FPV stability mode, then we're going to export it, and then in order to get back to this same orientation, we're going to have to use a different editing software program to return it to its normal landscape orientation. But for now, let's just show you how to go ahead and activate FPV stability mode. And we do that once we've captured the video using our camera and uploaded it to our desktop or our phone app. We go over here and we can turn on and off flow state stabilization, or we can turn on FPV stabilization. Remember, flow state stabilization is going to lock the horizon and won't follow our flips and rolls, which, as I mentioned earlier, is good for cinematic flights without acrobatics. If you're going to be doing freestyle acrobatics and you want the video to follow your maneuvers, then here's how you activate FPV stabilization. You just toggle this on. It rotates the video, as I mentioned, which means once we export it, we're going to have to use a different software program to reorient it to its landscape position. For now, we've got FPV stabilization activated, and we're just going to export it. So now that our file has been exported from our Insta360 Studio 2020 desktop application to our folder on our desktop computer, We can edit it however we want and share it to social media or YouTube or what have you. But for now, we're done here. Let's go ahead and take a look at different mounting options for our Insta360 GO camera with quadcopters. Of course, for forward-looking shots, we could use one of the accessories, or a 3D printed mount from Brain3D, or rubber bands and foam, which works on 2-inch quads too, or a horizontal 3D printed mount. For rear shots, we can turn it around, or zip tie it to the bottom of an arm, or look straight down using zip ties. Now let's do our flight demos with both flow state and FPV stabilizations.
So that's the Insta360 GO Sports Action Camera's FPV features. Tiny in both size and weight, with both flow state and FPV stabilization. Capable of shooting 5 minutes at a time, portable between all of your quads, and with unlimited mounting options to capture whatever perspective you want for any of your flights. Let me know in the comments section below your thoughts on its uses for FPV. Are you going to get one? Make sure to hit that like button below to help the YouTube algorithm show it to other FPV pilots. Subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every time I publish a new video. For more good info to speed you on your journey to better FPV fun, make sure to check these out next. Thanks for your time. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.